Hi, so today ngira kubira ku electric cars, purely electric cars. Nga unalaba this Tesla Cybertruck, or whether it's a Model S, or even an electric car from BYD company na yeye kola electric cars. So why are these guys, wachi wana bazungu ba pushinga these electric cars? Nina chukuna nyoleji. But just imagine 50 years from now, in 2024, 2074, 2074, you're driving your electric car, whether it's the Tesla car, charging petrol stations, tezichaliwa, garage replaced by charging stations. Tegera, techari kunywa mafuta, just charging, ago na charging the similar car. Actually, ne waka ubosolo charging la yo, motoka yo, ya masanyalaji. So no more hassle with fuel. Right, actually, these electric cars ziyamba okendeza ne kuki cost of service oza zo ziba tezina internal combustion engine, tezina engine, tezina zimanya exhaust, tezina fuel tank, tegeza transmission nayo ya njawulo, so tegenda mu ATF, so radiator tewali, so cost of service ajja kuba akola ki attended. So why are these bazungus pushing these electric cars? We're actually pushing electric cars because European Union, they have one sale 50 years from now. Why not transitioning all these companies like General Motors, Toyota, Chrysler, Benz, Volkswagen? They have to transition from these fuel cars to fully electric. Fine, kati walu bakola nezi hybrid cars. Hybrid cars ndio zana zimani. They are part of fuel kwa masanyalaze then na mafuta. It's a combination of what of tunaye. They have to fully transition to purely electric cars. Right? Lwaki bapushinga nyo these electric cars? So these guys are just simply concerned about the climate, right? This perception, because these fuel cars, like they're emitting out sometimes carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxides of nitrogen. So carbon dioxide is toxic and highly dangerous. Like carbon dioxide, fine, ebimera bimwetaga for photosynthesis. That's the basic science. Like plants zimwetaga to carry out photosynthesis. But then ebimera bibanga tebimukozeseza. Okitegeera. Ekibeerawo kiba bwe kiti. Like carbon dioxide yono agenda waggulu in the sky. So it creates a blanket on the earth. Together, we're creating a blanket for us. So, omusana we're going to be emitting light rays. Omusana, so light rays is as you know, we are reflected. Like laws of reflection, muzimanya. That's basic physics. They have to reflect the light rays going back, bouncing back. Is kona ku earth, then is bouncing back. But we go kubera ko blanket here, yo. That's carbon dioxide. These light rays will be trapped. If they are trapped, so ujja kulaba nga ebbugumu lyeyongera, ekyo kye bayita global warming. As simple as that. So global warming. So when wagai they think in the next like 1 million years, if nothing is done, humanity will be extincted. Like abantu bajja kubeera extincted. So they are concerned about the future generation because tujja beerawo within 1 million years. But then it's the future generation, right? So if nothing is done about the climate change, humanity will be extinct and wiped out from the face of the earth. So that's why they are much concerned. So one of the biggest cause of this climate change is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide have more automotive, more cars, more motor cars, you know, is it gasoline and petrol, right? So that's why they are pushing to green energy. That's electric cars. Electric cars, they omit zero emissions, because it's just battery, motor, and your motor ketambula. So that's why they are always pushing for these electric cars, right? So the future of electric cars, and it's real, transformationally real. For example, in those developed countries already, they have already built charging stations, different places, they make malls, particular charging stations for those electric cars, right? So ne waka nayo osobola charging nayo musegera. So within the market, they are already in the market, they are existing in the market. But in other countries, example in third world countries, they have to wait for that change, because they have to embrace also for that change, because it's coming. One day, one time, within like 40 years from now or 30 years, they have to come here in Uganda. So, but in already, of course, hybrid already in Uganda, I think Toyota in a hybrid with some other companies, but for electric cars, purely electric, they have to come here. So that will be a game changer. So technicians or mechanics, they have to upgrade their knowledge so that they can be able to service those electric cars. So now we're going to be dealing with more petrol stations, so they have to transition to to maybe charging stations, right? So it will be a game changer. So that's the future of electric cars, and why are they pushing so hard for electric cars?